Voters in Multnomah County, Oregon, where Portland is located, could replace their progressive district attorney, Mike Schmidt, with a far more moderate candidate and a co-worker of his, which could signal yet another sign of backlash over criminal justice reforms and reformers. Now, should Nathan Vasquez prevail, that's the individual challenging him, it would represent more than the rejection of a progressive prosecutor. It would be a continuation of what we've been seeing in this county and in the state of Oregon, where there's been growing frustration among voters in regard to some of the issues they've been facing, and they're looking for someone to place the blame on. Mike Schmidt happens to be one of those individuals. Now, Mike Schmidt's challenger, Nathan Vasquez, points to the declining size of police and a plunge in prosecution since 2020 under Schmidt. Prior to him coming into office, we ranged somewhere between 12,000 to 20,000 cases a year, said the challenger. Under him, post-COVID, we were under 6,000, referring to the lack of prosecutions pertaining to crimes that are committed in the county. Now, residents seem to agree with him, including a gentleman named Dwight Holton. He's a Democrat and a former US attorney who lives in Portland. He told Politico for their lengthy piece, quote, "The white left decided anarchists were better than cops." And there is some truth behind that, because the dwindling number of police has led to this big boom in the private security industry. And so the county signed a 5-year, $40 million contract earlier this year with a California-based firm for a California-based firm. Interesting. For armed and unarmed security at libraries, homeless shelters, and county offices. Holton, that's the resident that we heard from earlier, faults folks outside Portland treating us as a lab for policy experiments and what were clearly failed experiments. That includes groups such as the Drug Policy Alliance, a New York-based organization that helped bankroll the ballot measure decriminalizing hard drugs and is now a major funder of Schmidt. And the drug decriminalization legislation or law was in fact rolled back after proving to be a pretty epic failure. Faced with voter fury, writes Politico, open air drug dealing and usage along with spiraling deaths, Oregon's Democratic governor and legislature ended up approving a bill to recriminalize possession of even small amounts of such drugs, which is something I kind of warned about. If we don't kind of get a handle on the open air drug market situation, well, then the pendulum is going to swing right back in a direction that people on the left aren't going to like. And in a state that saw a surge in opioid overdoses in 2023, 628 in the first 6 months of the year, compared to 280 in all of 2019, the repeal represented an admission of a failed policy change. And because of the failed policies, the pendulum again is very likely to swing right back to what progressive activists don't want. And a few weeks after Governor Tina Kotick signed the recriminalization, the Oregonian went into the field with a poll and found that 78% of voters in Metro Portland believe homelessness is a very serious problem. And get a load of this, over 60% said that local government should be allowed to fine or arrest anyone who refuses to leave public spaces. So I'm not surprised by the backlash at all. I saw this coming from a mile away, was hoping to avoid the backlash in order to ensure that we could actually focus on reforms that work, but that didn't happen. So we'll see what happens with this DA race, but it's not looking good for Schmidt at the moment.
Pausing here to deliver some honest truth, as we do in our news coverage as well. TYT is facing challenges, guys, as the entire industry is. You know who could make the difference? You. If you hit the join button below, it's gonna make all the difference and keep us in business. We appreciate you, thank you.
So I think this is a really interesting story, because it also goes to the question of who is a progressive, which I'm gonna come back to in a second. But first I wanna tell you a devastating fact. So before this guy came into office, they had arrests that were in the ballpark of 12 to 20,000 cases a year. Okay, so you could say, hey, maybe that's a lot. Maybe there was too many marijuana possession things in there, etc. But you know what they are with him now? They're under 6,000. So he cut arrests by either 50%, depending on the year, or 2/3. Really? 2/3 of the people you were arresting in Portland were innocent? That doesn't seem right. Like, so what are we doing here? How is this criminal justice reform? Criminal justice reform is don't do things that are unjust. Don't beat up black people for no reason. Don't shoot them in the back. Don't train the cops to shoot before figuring out who the hell they're shooting at. Don't arrest people for minor marijuana possession. It's the equivalent of having a course. Like, these are all the conversations you guys heard us having for years, right? Did you guys ever hear us say, just don't arrest half the criminals? So the reason why the numbers that Anna read you about what the residents of Portland think are so important is because Portland is universally considered the most progressive city in the country. So in fact, there's a whole show called Portlandia about how outrageously progressive Portland is. If 78% of them are worried about this prosecutor, are we sure the prosecutor is progressive? I don't think that just letting criminals go is a progressive position. And here is the overwhelming majority of the voters in the most progressive city in America saying, that is not a progressive position. That is not what we asked for. You just made that up. And so we asked for normal, rational criminal justice reform. We didn't say let everyone go. We didn't ask for Bain. We asked for Bernie Sanders. So right. Now there's going to be a course correction. My guess is he'll lose. Boudin has already been ousted in San Francisco. All the people who went to extremes and did things that progressives never asked for are going to lose. And they're going to lose in the most blue cities there are.
I'll give you another example specifically out of Portland. So in 2022, criminal justice reformer and activist Joanne Hardesty ended up losing her city council race after a single term. So she serves a single term and then she ends up losing to a moderate political novice from the business community, someone named Renee Gonzalez, who's now running for mayor this fall. And by the way, I mean, similar trends are taking place in other parts of the country as well. Let's go to Chicago, where progressive DA Kim Fox decided against running for re-election and was replaced in March by a former judge who pledged to prosecute retail theft as a felony and said that Fox, quote, did not believe in accountability. So the backlash is real, and it's cute if you're living in a gated community and you're doing well for yourself and you have a secure situation and you get to advocate for policies that impact the lives of other people in another community. But the people living in that community end up feeling the effects and then they start engaging in backlash against the left. And I don't know to what extent this is having an impact on the general election. This Politico piece, I felt, focused a little too much on Biden and how, Biden needs to take note. These are local policies and these are local politicians. I think it's ridiculous to blame Biden for it. Besides which, Biden has actually really made a point from the very beginning to denounce and reject the whole defund the police movement. He's always been in favor of, well-funded police departments. So I don't really think Biden's the issue here, even though I have my issues with Biden for other purposes. This is about local politics. It's about a national conversation that led to changes in local politics and some of the policies that have been implemented on a local level and some of the, more, I guess, like the DAs who would rather operate with impunity, toward criminals. Those are the individuals that are having an impact on these communities. And now there's the backlash. So I guess we'll see how it plays out for this particular DA race. But again, not surprised by it. Really not surprised by it. There's another situation playing out in Los Angeles where the progressive DA, George Gascon, has a challenger, a gentleman named Nathan Hochman, and it does appear that he's poised to beat Gascon in November.
Yeah, Hochman has a double digit lead, and it's Los Angeles, another city that is one of the most progressive cities in the country. I don't I don't accept that these DAs are progressive. So two things from this story. No, Anna, they call themselves progressive. Yeah, you can call yourself anything you like. Look, here, let's take a stat that Anna mentioned in the story. 60% said local governments should be allowed to fine or arrest anyone who refuses to leave public spaces. Again, that's in Portland, most liberal city in America, okay? 60%. And these anarchist DAs say, no, you should be allowed to do drugs in public. You should be homeless folks should be allowed. Like they in LA, they won't. Oftentimes, cops won't come to remove homeless folks from private property, people's homes. Like it's, I know the crazy left is never going to believe it. Oh, no, no. Everybody in every neighborhood is lying. We're the only ones that have the truth. Really? There's 60% of people in Portland going, no, you don't have the right to just come anywhere you like and do drugs or crime or whatever it is. So the progressive position is not pro-crime. I don't know where they got that in their crazy, crazy, crazy heads. Crime is an injustice by definition. Progressives are for justice. So this quote that really struck me in the story, and I know that it's, look, the guy saying that the white left is into anarchy, the one that Anna read you guys. I don't like the white black. I don't, but I know why he's saying. I don't know if that what race that brother is, okay? But I think that what they're referring to is oftentimes people who are not minorities come into these communities saying, "Oh, we're going to do what's right for you. We're going to let criminals go, especially if they're minorities." And the minority communities are like, how's that helping us? It's such a patronizing, kind of a disgusting attitude. And to me, okay, so that's half of it. The other half of it that's even more relevant is this is not progressive. It's in favor of anarchy if you say we just shouldn't be arresting people for quote unquote lower level crimes. Either it's a crime or it's not a crime. There's some things that shouldn't be a crime, okay? But if we've decided that it's a crime, yeah, you arrest people for it. That's how it works. Otherwise, massive injustice against the citizens arise as has happened in these cities.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.